What I'm doing today is one technique only, and that is weightless wacky worms. And the best bet, if you want to fish with just one type of bait, is clear all of the other baits off of your boat. The habit is, if you don't get anything within the first few minutes of trying one technique, the tendency is always to switch up and not give the bait that you're trying to work enough time to actually work. So if you clear all the other baits off your boat and come out on a trip like this with just rods rigged for the technique that you're planning on trying, you've got a much better chance of succeeding because you'll put more time in. Try different techniques using that bait, different colors, until you get it to work. So today it's all about weightless wacky. You might be able to see that I've got a braided mainline. It's about a 15 pound braided mainline. There's one with a fluoro leader, and I really like that mainline just so that when I'm dropping those worms and the line is slack, I can actually see the line. Oh, nice little largy. I can see the line moving on the surface, and that gives me an indication that I've got something playing on the other end. And this area holds, there we go. This area holds largemouth, smallmouth, ooh, as well as pike, walleye, and lake trout. But right now I'm just targeting the bass. First largemouth. That's a nice specimen there. Beautiful colors on these fish. Weightless wacky. Okay. Get him back in, and I want to show you something when he goes in. Swimming off, look at this. This is what he spat out. One perch. Two perch. And a somewhat digested unknown entity. That one looks more like a shiner than a perch, but obviously aggressively feeding, good sign. I'm just working very close into the shoreline. I'm actually pitching these into about a foot of water and then just bringing them back out. And there's a fairly significant drop right about there. And it seems like these fish are holding, here's another, they're holding just off that drop. Again, that's where it's important with this braided line, or at least a line that you can see. You can just see that line movement when that worm is dropping. Because it's non-weighted, so you lose contact with it briefly as it's sinking. Oh, there's another one. Oh, he's coming in. Little guy. Little tiny guy. Unfortunately, you have to contend with quite a few of these. But hey, that's fun too. Nice clean little smallmouth. All right, let's do a few casts along this point, see what we've got. Let's work, start a little deeper. There's one. Whoa, nice. Right on cue, right at that point, too. Another largemouth. These weren't seen too much in this lake a few years ago, but recently there's been a huge, huge explosion in their population. Oh, here's another nice largemouth. About the same size as the last one. Nice, healthy fish. Good fat fish, feeding well. Nice to see. Amigos. Okay, no secret to the colors yet. This one is a burnt orange and a dark brown combination, and the other one was watermelon. Found a lot of times too when they're feeding like this, it really doesn't matter what you throw at them. I've moved up to a weed edge here very shallow water, and this would be the best place to use something like frog or mice imitations, but I'm just going to work the edge and see if there are any larches that are just underneath these pads of weeds that might want to come out for a worm. There we go. Little guy. Right where he should have been too. Right on that, probably hiding under that weed flat. Nice. There he is. Beautiful fish. Nice. So that was right in that weed line. Just casting in right beside the weeds. Again, like I said, the frogs would be a great option here because you could go right on top of that weed edge. But here, I'm just casting right at the edge of them and just seeing what will come out. That's the first one out of that line. And we'll keep moving forward and see what else we can pull out of there. As he swims off. Now, I have to re-rig, but that color seems to be working well. Browns, oranges. I'll just rig another of those up for now, and then I think after that, if I get another of those, I'm just going to switch up, try another color. The name of the game today is just working the wacky worm combination, and I want to try as many different patterns, sizes, and colors as I can. It's been a lot of loon activity as well along this side, right along this shelf that's adjacent to the island that I'm fishing. Always a good sign. If they're feeding, there's bait around. If there's bait around, there's predators around. So keep an eye out for those birds. A lot of surface activity. And that's actually in the shallower water. That's on the top of that extension of the point from this island. Those fish are surfacing right on the edge of the point. Might have to throw a few in a little bit tighter. There we go. Keep an eye on those fish, keep an eye on those birds. Surfacing fish in the shallows, the fish are in a bit shallower. First cast in shallower. Oh, nicer one too. That's a nice one. Wow. Ah, that's better. That's much better. That is another nice, fat, largemouth. He's just got that one just in the roof of his mouth. Here we go. Look at that. Nothing wrong with that fish at all. Beautiful. Look at the fat bellies on these fish. Well fed. But again, that was just watching the fish surfacing in the shallows on the tops of the shoal points. And I put the first cast in there, first fish. Nice. Okay, well, I worked that island over really well. I worked the windswept side of the island throughout the rocks that are strewn along the shoreline. I worked through that, got a number of largemouth out of there. I also worked the extension of the point of the island that goes out into the main lake, and I got another one out of there, so I'm quite happy with that. So instead of continuing to work that area, I know there are fish there, I can come back tomorrow and try some different techniques and work those. But what I want to do is continue with this wacky worm setup, but working different types of structure. So what I'm doing now is moving to a place that I've fished before on the other side of the lake, and that's got a different structure, and that structure is sunken trees. And I love fishing around sunken trees for any species of fish. So I'm going to see if I can pull another largemouth or two out from there. There might be some smallies in that area too. I've caught big smallies in there before. And there are also a few pike. So we'll see what we can work out of those. And then we'll just look for other areas of structure that are different that we can try the same technique on. There's one. Right off the hop, little guy. And it looks like our first little smallmouth too. First little smallmouth. Now that first sunken tree that I was hoping to get fish off didn't produce very well, but I've just moved into another bay. And again, this is just a very, very small sample, but just moved into another bay and there's more sunken foliage down here too. So, you know, take advantage of that and see if I can't get a few more of those. It's a very late start to the summer. So it's taken a while for the weeds to mature. But now that they're in full bloom, there's some good cover for the fish. And areas like this that hold all three elements of the key cover and structure should be really productive. Oh, there we go. Oh, he's a feisty one. And that one was out of the weeds. So one off of a sunken tree. Oh, nice jump. And another smallie here, and this guy came right out of that cluster of weeds. That's a slightly better one. He's off the hook. Look at how dark that is. Nice fish. Two for two. Well, that's it for today for Wacky Worm Rigging for large and smallmouth bass along shorelines. I hope you enjoyed what you saw, and if you did, please like and subscribe. I really appreciate that, and tune in again tomorrow where I'll be drop shotting on some of the deep water shoals in this same lake. Thanks.